that when I tell you, it came out, and I had a conference last year, it was called Rejection and Rejection is Common Field. And it was in Atlanta, and God dealt with me on some things, even there, you know, he dealt with me on some things, but it wasn't things of the past. It was things that he's trying to move me into, but I had to move some stuff out of the way in order to get to the next level, which is happening. So I'm on my way. But it was a song, and I asked the young lady to do it at the conference, and she broke down. She couldn't finish the song, and that's when I knew it was a song that was ordained by God. And it's called Destiny by Tina Campbell. And it's one of the songs I absolutely love because it speaks my heart. It tells where I'm trying to go. It tells that I don't look like what I've been through, and you don't see it through me. God does those things, but you have to be open. You have to be willing to let him in. So see, it's twofold. Even though you want to connect to God, you have to align him down in those great areas, in those hidden places that you don't let anybody into. When you're restricting people, when I love you, but I love you this much, or I can love you enough, you have to be willing to be completely vulnerable with God. You have to let him all the way in. You can't give him a piece of you and tell him to work on that, but you're going to work on the other end, and you're going to keep this over here for yourself. Those are the things that you can't do. When you want to heal, honestly, it gets ugly. It gets really, really, really ugly. You cry. You feel pain. You feel hurt. You probably feel as though you're dying, but it's because you are. You're dying to all that old stuff that was there, and God is creating someone new. So you have to die to self in order to have a new release. So it's going to hurt. I'm not going to tell you it's going to be easy, and it's going to feel good. But when God starts dealing with those things, with that stuff, with the people, with the grudges, with everything that you're holding on to, you see a new person emerge. And guess what else? Everybody else see that new person emerge also. They try to figure out, girl, you gotta go. What's going on? I've heard that over and over. Yeah. Well, you know, you think God is Jesus. Would you like me to introduce you to him? That's what you do. The glow is the light of God and the light of his place on the inside of you, because he's worked through all those dark places. He's worked through all those empty places, all that emptiness, all that brokenness has now been mended. You've been made whole. And so when you're made whole, guess what? You're going to look holes all over your body. People don't see great anymore. They can see the light because they can shine out brighter. They can. But you have to know you have that destiny. You have to know that God is real. You have to know that God can do it. You have to be able to trust him and have your faith in him. The one thing they told me before I gave my phone, the one thing I was told a few years ago is that I was gifted in faith. And I didn't know what that meant at that time. I just knew when God said, do something, I obeyed. Okay, well, what does that really look like? What it looks like is, at the age of 24, I left Atlanta. I mean, I left Miami to go to Atlanta alone because God told me to move. My friends and my family were in Miami. I didn't have anybody in Atlanta. But God said, go. And guess what? Me and God had a nice little conversation. How you moving me? All my people here. I don't want to rule by it. But you know what God began to tell me as I drove down the road, tears streaming down my eyes, in the midst of rain, when I'm like, what about my mom? What about my family? What about my friends? Who's going to take care of me? We had that conversation, and God told me, I'm your family. I am your friend, and I'm going to take care of you. You need to move. You need to go. And I realized years later that God couldn't get to me in Miami because I had everybody else to depend on. I had everybody else to trust in. He couldn't get to me. He couldn't get me here. He couldn't get me here because I can call mom, or I can call Lou, or I can call sister, I can call family, and everybody come running happened on that line. I couldn't call mama because every time I called mama, she was like, I'm coming to get you. I'm driving to it and I'm coming to bring you home. So I had to stop calling mama and telling them how I was feeling. I'm coming to get you. I had to stop calling friends because why don't you just move back home? Why aren't you putting yourself back? Those were the disconnections I needed to make. And I found myself down the street in a church called Antioch in Atlanta, wrapped in my car in the midst of Atlanta, praying to God. You said you wouldn't leave me. You told me you were going to take care of me. I'm having friends. I'm alone. I just don't feel like this is a good move. And God started pouring that out. When have you left? When have I left you? You have food in your house. You have been well taken care of. You have a job. Just because you don't see people don't mean I'm not here. Just because I haven't placed you around with other people don't mean that I'm not going to put you in an atmosphere for people. You have to break it off and be alone in order for God to be able to place you in the midst of the platform. You can't be around a lot of people. And so that was one of my favorite. Not to mention saying no to some of everything because I had faith that if I prayed and if God told me not how to do it, I just didn't do it. I didn't offer an explanation. I didn't render that excuse. I don't care who you are. I didn't respect it. But when God told me to move or when God told me to do something, I did it. My mom moved to Atlanta years later. Guess what God did? You need to move to South Carolina. And so I ended up leaving home in LA and coming on to South Carolina. We didn't understand it, but guess what? It was another move alone. Another move alone. And that's what she said, whenever I come somewhere, you leave. So I'm coming to South Carolina. And it's fine, but I had to live here for another piece of my purpose, for another piece of the destiny. There are things I went through here that I haven't gone through in Atlanta and in Miami, but they shaped who I am. They shaped my destiny. And so, I have a destination in my view. The road may be bumpy, but I'm pressing.
Our last set of door prizes.